Hello and welcome to The Social Connection. It's your program about social media news, the trends you talked about, the videos you shared, and what new changes social media companies offer its users. My name is Venkat Raman and with me is Preeti Tiwari.
Thank you, Venkat. Welcome everyone. We are back with yet another edition in which we'll take you through the top trends, latest news and everything that kept the social media platform busy. But first up, let's take a look at what we have in store for you in this edition.
Users can soon use mini videos as profile pictures on Facebook for mobile.
Google to help India set up base for Wi-Fi at 500 railway stations.
Mark Zuckerberg announces global campaign on internet connectivity.
Well, let's start with the top stories now. To keep its decade-old social network lively, the social media giant Facebook is introducing 5 big changes to user profiles. With this, mobile users will be able to use 7-second-long homemade GIFs on their main picture on the site. The features begin rolling out and testing this week for some users on their mobile phones. Take a look.
Before the news feed, Facebook's profile pages were the main source of action on the social network. Explaining why the social media giant is giving them a facelift, the company said profile pages still get more than 4 billion views a day. The changes headed to mobile profile pages are aimed at getting ever more video added to Facebook and nudging people to use profiles as a personal and maybe even professional home base. In some cases, the new features play catch up to other social networks like Snapchat and Twitter. And as usual, Facebook says the overhaul gives customers more control. As with most product rollouts, the changes are happening to a small group first and will hit others at a later time. Once recorded and uploaded, they will only animate if someone visits your profile, not in everyone's newsfeed. Profile photos can also be set as temporary images for certain events, reverting back to your standard pouty smizing face once the World Cup or whatever else has proved cause for novelty overlay has ended. Both profile photos and videos are now bigger and centered on the page, making them harder to ignore. The new profile videos can only be uploaded via the Facebook app or iPhones and only for users in the UK and California for now. Despite being exclusive to Apple's iOS at the moment, Apple's new live photos are not supported. Facebook profiles also now have a small space just under the action buttons for people to write whatever they like, just like Twitter's bios. Emojis, words, missives or an actual biography are all welcome, as are up to 5 featured photos. Anyone who can see your profile on Facebook will be able to see the new bio space. Other information on your profile can be shown or not based on extensive criteria around friends, friends of friends, public and so on. Indian Railways and Google will work together to install high-speed Wi-Fi connections in 500 railway stations. And this announcement was made by Prime Minister Narendra Modi during his visit to Silicon Valley last week. Prime Minister also announced a plan to create an aggressive expansion of the national optical fiber network to take broadband to 6 lakh villages. We bring you more in this report.
Indian Railways and Google would work together to install high-speed Wi-Fi connection in 500 railway stations, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said during his visit to the Silicon Valley. PM Modi visited Google headquarters in California, where he was received by its Indian origin Chief Executive Officer Sundar Pichai. PM Modi is the first Indian leader to visit the US West Coast in more than 30 years. His trip follows a similar visit by China's President Xi Jinping, who met several tech leaders in Seattle last week. A special Google doodle dedicated to PM Modi's project Make in India initiative was on display to welcome the Prime Minister. Pichai explained to PM Modi the navigational, safety and other uses of Street View and Google Earth. He was shown India's iconic Taj Mahal and northern holy town of Varanasi on the satellite imaging software. Google gave a tour of its 4 critical projects to PM Modi. The Prime Minister was given a view of Project Iris, a smart lens that measures glucose levels. PM Modi said that Google will help India set up base for Wi-Fi connection at 500 railway stations in collaboration with the Indian Railways.
अब भारत का रेलवे और गूगल मिलकर के 500 रेलवे स्टेशन पर वाईफाई का बड़ा अभियान कर रहे हैं और भारत की रेलवे मतलब यूरोप का एक देश पूरी तरह हमारे यहाँ रेलवे में होता है
Meanwhile, Pichai said that Google was very excited to work with the Indian Railways and contribute towards Digital India.
So we are very excited. We are starting with 100 of the busiest railway stations. 10 million passengers go through that every day. and we hope to expand it to 400 stations by the end of next year. And we are talking about high definition video streaming being possible on these connections. So this is very, very high speed for that. And we are doing all this to support the vision of Prime Minister and his Digital India.
Pichai also said that from next month, Google will also roll out Indic language typing on Android. PM Modi is the second most popular world leader on the social media after US President Barack Obama. He has 15 million Twitter followers and more than 30 million likes on Facebook. He also attended a dinner with 350 business leaders where Indian-born CEOs like Satya Nadella of Microsoft Corporation, Google Sundar Pichai and Shantanu Narayan of Adobe System moderated a panel. PM Modi also visited Tesla Motors headquarters and met its CEO Elon Musk, where the two discussed battery technology, energy storage and renewable energy. He also met Apple CEO Tim Cook. During the United Nations Private Sector Forum, Facebook co-founder Mark Zuckerberg announced a global joint effort to launch a campaign to support a declaration of connectivity. The campaign aims to make internet access a global priority. Here's more in this report.
Facebook co-founder Mark Zuckerberg and U2 frontman Bono were some of the guests to join UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon and German Chancellor Angela Merkel at the United Nations Private Sector Forum 2015. The forum, part of the Global Compact Initiative, focuses on the role of the private sector in implementing the Sustainable Development Goals and include a 15-year global plan of action to end poverty, reduce inequalities and protect the environment. In his opening remarks, the Secretary General spoke about the importance to mobilize the global business community.
Realizing the Sustainable Development Goals will improve the environment for doing business and building markets. Trillions of dollars in public and private funds are to be redirected towards the SDGs, creating huge opportunities for responsible companies to deliver solutions.
German Chancellor Angela Merkel, who during her morning address at the General Assembly called for a reform of the UN Security Council to reflect the redistribution of power across the world, said that the link between sustainability, development and good economic policies was good news for the private sector.
The good news for you, for the private sector, is that sustainable development and a good economy go hand in hand.
Das gute Wirtschaften hand in hand gehen.
Zuckerberg said that internet connectivity was a human right and announced a global joint effort to launch a campaign to support a declaration of connectivity to make internet access a global priority.
I'm pleased to announce that Facebook is partnering with the One Campaign, the One Organization and leaders and public figures all over the world to launch a global campaign to support a connectivity declaration. The declaration recognizes internet access as an important enabler of human rights.
Zuckerberg also said his company would be partnering with the UN to support the millions of refugees escaping war and poverty and gain online connectivity.
I'm also pleased to announce today that Facebook will be partnering with the UN to advance our common goals. In the short term, to address the current crisis, we will be working with UNHCR to bring the internet to refugee camps. Connectivity will help refugees better access support from the aid community and maintain their links to family and loved ones. And Facebook is in a unique position to help maintain this lifeline.
U2 frontman and philanthropist Bono also took to the stage to speak about the need for the private sector to bridge the gap of economic inequality.
I'm late to realizing that, you know, it's you guys, it's the private sector, that's really, it's commerce that's going to take the majority of people out of extreme poverty. And as an activist, I almost found that hard to say.
He also said that today's consumers are not just seeking value when they purchase goods or services, but values.
It seems that consumerism is changing and people are realizing the power they have in their pockets. They vote when they make a purchase and they vote for your brands or they don't. And these days, people are waking up to that power they have in their pocket and they want not just value. It seems they want values.
With the support of business and other stakeholders, the UN Global Compact's governance framework was adopted by former UN Secretary General Kofi Annan in 2005 with a mandate to promote responsible business practices and UN values among the global business community and the UN system. We are heading for a short commercial break. We have lots of interesting stories coming up. Stay tuned and keep watching DD News.
Welcome back. You must be familiar with the top trending topics of the week, but here's a quick wrap of the trends that rule different social media platforms this week.
The nation remembered Mahatma Gandhi on his 146th birth anniversary with President Pranab Mukherjee, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Congress Chief Sonia Gandhi and other leaders paying floral tributes to him at his memorial Rajghat in New Delhi. This was one of the top trending and talking topics of the week. Mahatma Gandhi was born on this day in the year 1869 in Porbandar, Gujarat. Swachh Bharat Mission completed 1 year on 2nd October. The cleanliness campaign, launched on the occasion of Gandhi Jayanti by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, has witnessed huge success across the country. On the Clean India campaign, Prime Minister wrote in a message, "Cleanliness was very close to Mahatma Gandhi's heart. Let us reaffirm our commitment for a Swachh Bharat and fulfill our beloved Bapu's dream. A clean India will enhance our development journey and benefit the poor." The Indian Railways also said that it will continue the Swachh Bharat mission till March 2016. This made Swachh Bharat mission one of the trending topics on Facebook and Twitter. President Pranab Mukherjee leads the nation in paying tribute to India's former Prime Minister Lal Bahadur Shastri on his 111th birth anniversary. Vice President Hamid Ansari, President of India's opposition Congress Party Sonia Gandhi and ruling Bharatiya Janata Party's veteran leader L.K. Advani were among those who paid homages to Shastri. Shastri was the second Prime Minister of independent India and was in office from June 9, 1964 to January 11, 1966. He was an avid follower of Mahatma Gandhi and was associated with the Indian National Congress. Shastri was the first person to be posthumously awarded the Bharat Ratna, the country's highest civil award. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who was away from New Delhi, tweeted, "I bow to the proud son of India, Sri Lal Bahadur Shastri, on his birth anniversary." External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj, addressing UN General Assembly in a speech, was one of the talking points of the week. "Give up terrorism and let's sit down and talk," Sushma Swaraj said in response to Pakistan's four-point peace initiative. PM Modi praised Sushma Swaraj for her excellent speech at the United Nations General Assembly. The first look of upcoming movie Prem Ratan Dhan Payo was shared by Bollywood actor Salman Khan. Salman Khan plays a double role in the film. He took to Twitter on Tuesday to share the teaser poster of director Suraj Barjatya's Prem Ratan Dhan Payo. It was a huge buzz on all social media platforms. The movie is set for a November 11 theatrical release. Prem Ratan Dhan Payo also features Sonam Kapoor, Neel Nitin Mukesh and Anupam Kher. The movie is directed by Suraj R. Barjatya.
The last date for submission of nominations for the hashtag 100 Women Achievers contest has been extended till 10th October 2015 due to overwhelming response from the people. Voting for the contest will begin on November 7th on the top 200 entries as determined by the jury. Have a look at this report.
Due to overwhelming response from the public, the last date for submission of nomination for the hashtag 100 Women Achievers contest has been extended to 10th October 2015. The Union Ministry of Women and Child Development in collaboration with Facebook has launched the hashtag 100 Women initiative in July. The initiative aims at recognizing and acknowledging women who are making a difference in their community across the country. The hashtag 100 Women initiative involves a contest to select 100 women achievers of India through public nominations via social media. Speaking about the initiative, the Union Minister for Women and Child Development, Menaka Gandhi, said, "We have all had women in our lives who have made a difference, who have changed the course of our own lives, who have left a mark on the entire community and changed it for the better. We don't thank them enough. Here is our chance to honor the women who have made a difference to your community."
All had women in our lives who've made a difference, who've changed the course of our own lives, who've left a mark on the entire community and changed it for the better. We don't thank them enough. All these wives and mothers and teachers and counselors, here is your chance to honor the women who have made a difference to your community, to your own life. Log on to my ministry's page, the Ministry for Women and Child Development. Share a video with us on why the women you choose should be honored as India's 100 most powerful women.
Log on to the Facebook page of the Ministry of Women and Child Development, share a video with us and why the women you choose should be honored as India's 100 most impactful women. To submit their nomination, people can visit the Ministry of Women and Child Development Facebook page between July 15th and October 10, 2015 and complete the nomination form. They will need to submit a photo or video showing the nominee in action in their community. Winners will be announced in December 2015. Voting will begin on November 7, 2015 on the top 200 entries as determined by an esteemed jury. Winners will be invited to join a reception organized by the Ministry around Republic Day. Ankhi Das, Director of Public Policy in South and Central Asia at Facebook said, "This is a great opportunity for us to celebrate women who have made a difference in our communities. We are delighted to have this opportunity to celebrate and recognize the women of India." Celebrities like Madhuri Dixit and Mahendra Singh Dhoni have voiced their support for this initiative. Well, don't go anywhere else as we are heading for a short commercial break. We'll be back in a short while. Stay tuned and keep watching DD News.
Welcome back to The Social Connection. Pinterest announced the opening of its developer sandbox, enabling any developer to access its application programming interface and start building apps and integrations. Now, when developers are ready to go public, they need to be submitted to Pinterest for approval. Have a look at this report.
Pinterest announces that its application programming interface is now fully available out of beta, allowing developers to integrate content from Pinterest into their own apps. As a follow-up to the Pinterest Developers Platform debut earlier this year, the Sandbox offers a suite of endpoints for building apps and integrations that enhance pins and help people do more with them. Such endpoints help drive traffic to your site, provide users with personalized recommendations and more. Previously, developers needed to get access by Pinterest to start building with application programming interface. Now, anyone can start building Pinterest apps and integrations. They just need Pinterest approval to go public. Pinterest has also made available a number of application programming interface and sample application that provides examples of what you can do with the new scripts to enhance your already existing Android, iOS and JavaScript application on new projects currently in development. When third-party apps are ready to launch publicly, developers need to submit them to Pinterest for review and approval. Since May, developers have submitted more than 5,000 ideas for apps and integrations, including recipe recommendations apps, travel planning apps, gift registry integration, publisher integration, and more.
Well, it's time to see all the feedback that you sent in on Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube.
Well, this is the end of our show. Continue sending in your feedback, comments as you have been on ddnews.com at gmail.com, on our Twitter handle at @ddnewslife, on our Facebook page and also on our YouTube channel.
Well, we hope that you enjoyed the show as much as we did in presenting it to you. And before we sign off, we leave you with an interesting video. See you again next week. Thank you and goodbye.
Improving human life across generations so that our children and grandchildren may have tomorrow what we enjoy today. That is sustainable development. Over the next 15 years, governments and peoples across the globe will embark on a journey to make this dream a reality. To make ours the first generation to end extreme poverty and the last to be threatened by climate change. We need everyone to join with us. Only if we all work together to achieve the new Sustainable Development Goals will we reach them by 2030. That is why UNDP, inspired by youth from Saudi Arabia, is launching Digital Good, the first ever engagement platform where citizens of the world can actively support the global goals, where they can learn, act, take action, and give. where they can meet like-minded people from all parts of our planet, where they can help make a better future for all of us a reality. Join us today and become a member of Digital Good, so we can reach the goals, all 17 of them. Let's end poverty. Let's kick out inequality. Let's build peace and justice. Let's embark on this journey together. You, me, and Digital Good.